some magnificent memories of the past 2.5 weeks in Pyeongchang. And some of those images will never be forgotten by the athletes, by their nations, and by the people of the world. We often talk about the fact that it is about competing more than it is about winning, and some of the more compelling images are not necessarily from those who've stood on the platform and the podium at the end of their sport.
No, emotions are both ends of the scale, isn't it? And even those that achieve personal best but might not be a medal and they've exceeded their expectation, there's that emotion as well. I mean, it's just watching those pictures, yeah, it's brilliant. It makes the hairs on the back of your neck stand up, doesn't it?
Yeah, there were many posts by athletes who perhaps didn't come away with that medal, but they said their performance was golden in their mind. The work that had gone in over the previous 4 years to build up to these Olympic Games, that moment is golden. You go out and you try your best, and you be each and every one of them should be proud of how they performed in their individual events.
Yeah, I don't think people realize that athletes make all these sacrifices, but unless you've actually been through it, I don't think you can quite understand the amount of sacrifice that athletes give up to perform on a stage like this. And you know, just being here, you know, it's emotional for them, and it's great for us to watch. It's fantastic.
And you mentioned the 4 years of preparation. We're at the closing ceremony in Pyeongchang tonight. The preparation for a lot of those athletes started at the closing ceremony in Sochi. That's where they set their mind to these Olympic Games. And imagine every day you wake up and one of the first thoughts you have is towards this couple of weeks, and that's what they've been going through for the last 4 years of their lives.
I can't. She can.
It's so true. You're absolutely right. There are athletes, you focus as soon as the closing ceremonies happen, you're thinking about the next 4 years. Of course, there are seasons, there are World Cup events, there are World Championships that happen, but it's that focus. 4 years, it passes quickly, but it takes preparation day in and day out to show up at an Olympic Games and be ready to perform your best and strive for those medals.
And I guess the thing is, you know, the public watching, you mentioned World Cups and World Championships in between the Olympic Games, and you know, the public, whichever nation you want, always want their athletes to do the best they can, but a World Championship might not come at the right time in an athlete's planning for the next Olympics. And okay, they might not achieve in the public eye what they expect, but actually their eighth place, their ninth place, whatever it may be, is the stepping stone they're looking for because they've got a further goal.
There are two collections of people at any Olympic Games who are very special. The athletes naturally are one. The volunteers are another, because you couldn't do this sort of thing without the volunteers. And everywhere that we have gone over the past 3 or 4 weeks that we've been here, there's been a smile on the faces of the Koreans. They've been helpful, they've been welcoming, they've just been brilliant.
Yeah, they really have. I've been absolutely amazed by how warm and welcoming the Korean people have been. Smiles every day. Every volunteer that you pass is happy to see you. They wave to say good morning and wave to send you off at the end of the day. And that really has been such a beautiful part of these Pyeongchang Olympic Games.
Yeah, I couldn't put it better myself. They've just been really, really friendly, really welcoming. Yeah, it'd been fantastic.
And the other thing about an Olympic Games is that it is such a huge logistical exercise to get all of these people, not only the athletes, but the media who have come here in their tens of thousands, and the spectators who come from around the world, and to get everybody around a place like this where there can be some travel difficulties because of the weather. Again, that's work like clockwork. They should take a bow in that regard.
Yeah, it's extraordinary. I mean, it's phenomenal the amount of people that need to be moved around from A to B to Z. It's incredible. I've never seen so many buses or coaches driving around, and every one has been used. But I mean, it's been fantastic.
And I love the buses too. The buses that we've been riding on, some of the lighting in the buses that we've been travelling on has to be seen to be believed. It's like going back in time and being in a disco in the 1970s or 1980s.
And some of them have television screens bigger than I've got at home.
Yes.
And we've been able to watch the Olympics whenever we've been moving. And that's the one thing that's also struck me, is the connectivity and be able to get online, whether or not you're travelling back from a venue and you're trying to catch up on what's been happening in other venues and trying to keep across what's what's happening in other sports. The connectivity here has been fantastic.
Well, it's funny you should mention that, because when I was on the bus on the way in today, that epic hockey final that went on between the Olympic athletes of Russia and Germany, and there was just so many twists in the tale. And at one stage, when the score got to 3-2 in favour of Germany, we went through one of the tunnels underneath the mountains, which freezes the picture. We weren't in the tunnel for very long, and when we came out the end, it was 3-3, and they were headed for overtime. Wow.
It's all about timing, isn't it?
But it was just brilliant to be able to watch it.
Well, I can certainly say the energy that the volunteers bring and the atmosphere from the spectators and the host city, it's felt, the athletes feel that. That helps bring the energy, that creates the energy amongst the athletes and the events. And it is such an important piece to these Olympic Games and to what allows the athletes to bring their best performance.
I think the other thing to point out is the weather. It's been so severe. I mean, in the fortnight running up to these games, you know, talking minus 25 degrees centigrade, and that's colder than your household freezer. You know, and add to that the wind chill factor. I mean, and it's been, I mean, brutal. I mean, really has been brutal. And, you know, to get everything working in that sort of temperature is amazing. I mean, really is.
I can tell you tonight here at the stadium, though, we've got a beautiful evening, and we were worried about the weather because they had a rehearsal a few nights ago where they actually had to cancel a fair bit of the rehearsal because the weather was so severe. Yesterday, you couldn't see the mountains in front of you. The visibility was right down. Today, we arrived here to the Olympic Stadium with beautiful blue skies. Yes, it's cold, but it's an Olympic winter game, so you expect it to be hot. It couldn't be much better night tonight for the closing ceremony.
No, this is spectacular. And arriving to the stadium here, the sun was setting nicely. There was calmness to the air, and the energy starting to build. And it's just been a fantastic lead up to this closing ceremony.
And what we are going to see is something that a lot of people from around the world will be happy about, see and hear, and that is K-pop, because K-pop is such a part of the world here, and it is increasingly showing itself to the rest of the world. So that's going to be a big part of this ceremony.
Yeah, it is. It is going to be a lively segment to this closing ceremony, which actually I'm really looking forward to. It was fantastic in dress rehearsal. I think it's only going to be better here tonight, and some very young performers performing in front of, you know, millions, maybe billions of people around the world. It's going to be fantastic.
What about for you two, your memories of the events that you saw? What are the moments that stand out for you in all the memorable moments that you saw?
Oh, well, there's a lot to choose from. I think the most memorable moments come from seeing the Olympic spirit coming from the athletes, the winners sharing their experience with those that didn't finish in the medals and those that are there more participating, and to see all these athletes from all the different nations come together and perform on the same stage.
Yeah, it's certainly the sporting spirit within the athletes has been fantastic. And like we said before, you know, there are athletes here that have surpassed their expectations, there are those that have met their expectations, and some that sadly won't have met their expectations, but that will only drive them for the next 4 years to come back and prove a point, because they only want to prove a point to themselves. That's their driving force. So yeah, it's been fantastic, you know, without singling out one sort of person or situation.
One of the things I'll take away is the ability to see two of the greatest speed skaters, and not only speed skaters, but Olympic athletes, two of the greatest of all time in Irene Wüst and Sven Kramer, with the Netherlands dominance of the speed skating, and also to be at the short track speed skating and to experience the atmosphere of that. It is like a rock concert, and the Koreans just love that sport so much, and their involvement was great for their athletes, but they were also respectful and congratulatory from athletes of other nations when they were able to experience their big moments too.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think respect is something that runs quite deep in Korean culture, so that's certainly come through in the organisation and the athletes that you see. They're very respectful of everyone, and that's been a big part of these games too.
I mentioned the sense of sadness that we get when we come to these things. It is a bit of a party. And closing ceremonies have evolved and become that, and it's a mingling of the athletes from all of the nations as well. But there is that sense of sadness, because it's a very special time for everybody to come together and to experience this wonderful feeling that only an Olympic Games can bring you.
Yeah, it's been a spectacular 2 weeks, and now we've come to the end. We've had all this energy here, and we know that it's the end, but you also have this feeling that you don't want it to be over, and it will have to wait for this feeling, this energy, to come back in 4 years' time.
And isn't it a spectacular sight as we look down at Alpensia towards the left of your picture and the Pyeongchang Olympic Stadium, which is only going to be used for this ceremony, the opening ceremony a couple of weeks ago, and the Paralympic Games ceremonies too. So we're privileged to be here.
Yeah, absolutely, and it's looking fantastic. And well, we're almost about to get this closing ceremony underway, and we're very excited to see how it manifests itself.
The crowd has rolled in, spectators from all around the globe, and they've witnessed some magnificent sport, absolutely magnificent sport, over the last 17 days or so. And they're rugged up against the cold. Yes, it is a cool night, but as we look in the distance, we can see the top of the ski jumping tower, which towers over the International Broadcast Centre, which has housed the media from all over the world. We saw some spectacular fireworks in the opening ceremony. I'm sure we're going to see that again. We're also going to have a couple of medal ceremonies for the cross-country skiing, and of course so many emotional moments, including the extinguishing of the Olympic flame. That's all still ahead of us in this wonderful closing ceremony. The countdown is on, so after 17 magnificent days of cheers and tears, of triumph and heartbreak, of moments to last a lifetime, it's time to say farewell from Pyeongchang. So now, let's get this party started. And the key message of the closing ceremony tonight is the next wave. It's all about coordination and harmony, not the end so much as a new start, a new challenge.
Messieurs, merci d'accueillir le président de la République de Corée, Moon Jae-in, et le président du Comité international olympique, Thomas Barr, champion olympique d'escrime en 1976.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the president of the Republic of Korea, Moon Jae-in, and the president of the International Olympic Committee, Thomas Barr, Olympic champion, fencing 1976.
여러분, 대한민국 문재인 대통령과 1976년 올림픽 펜싱 챔피언인 국제올림픽위원회 토마스 바흐 위원장을 환영해 주시기 바랍니다.
What a proud moment for those two men. They were beaming with pride at the opening ceremony a couple of weeks ago, and now they come here with the job almost done, greeting the dignitaries from all around the world.
Mesdames et messieurs, le drapeau national de la République de Corée.
Ladies and gentlemen, the national flag of the Republic of Korea.
신사 숙녀 여러분, 대한민국 국기가 입장하겠습니다.
The flag is carried into the stadium by children from local elementary schools.
These children are students at Hwenge Elementary School and Daegwalyeong Elementary School.
강원도 횡계 초등학교와 대관령 초등학교에 재학 중인 23명의 어린이들입니다.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever pour l'hymne national de la République de Corée, interprété par le chanteur Sa-ik Chang et les 23 enfants de notre chorale.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the Korean national anthem performed by Sa-ik Chang and our children's choir.
태극기 개양과 함께 애국가 제창이 있겠습니다. 애국가는 장사익 님과 어린이들이 부르겠습니다. 모두 자리에서 일어나 주시기 바랍니다.
Mm-hmm. That was the magnificent voice of Jang Sa-ik, who's been part of the Korean music scene for almost a quarter of a century. So much of tonight's performance will feature electronic sound with traditional Korean music and dances. It's a powerful combination. 13-year-old guitarist Yang Tae-wan. How good was that?
Mesdames et messieurs, nous allons maintenant assister à l'entrée des drapeaux des pays qui ont participé aux Jeux de Pyeongchang 2018.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the flags of the delegations of the Pyeongchang 2018 Olympic Winter Games.
여러분, 2018 평창 동계올림픽 대회 참가국 기수단이 입장하겠습니다.
More than 90 nations competing in Pyeongchang in 2018. And as has become the tradition, all of the flags come in together, and not long after that, the athletes will do the same. And amongst those flags are the flags of several nations that we wouldn't necessarily expect to have representation at an Olympic Winter Games.
Of course, there are six national Olympic committees who made their Winter Olympic Games debuts here in Pyeongchang 2018, Malaysia, Singapore, Kosovo, Eritrea, Ecuador and Nigeria.
Mesdames, Messieurs, veuillez à présent accueillir les athlètes des 23e Jeux Olympiques d'hiver de Pyeongchang.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the athletes of the 23rd Olympic Winter Games.
이어서 제23회 평창 동계올림픽 대회 주인공인 선수들이 입장하겠습니다. 여러분, 그들을 큰 박수로 맞이해 주십시오.
What a wonderful moment for the athletes as they enter into the Olympic Stadium.
이때는 어느 때인고 허니 2018년 강원도 평창 산바람 바닷바람 멈추니 꽃과 얼음꽃이 활짝 피어난 곳에서 신명나는 한판 펼쳐.
Of course, a lot of athletes go home before the end of the games, but Team Canada seem to be here in force this evening.
They have a strong team out as they enter the stadium. They've had a wonderfully successful Olympic Games.
And the idea of all of the athletes intermingling and walking in, not necessarily behind their national flag as they do in the opening ceremony, was born in 1956 at the Melbourne Olympic Games. There was a Chinese apprentice carpenter. His name was John Ian Wing. And he had the idea, why not mix the athletes up at the closing ceremony? Why not bring them all together and virtually march as one nation? It began in 1956 and it continues to this day.
Yeah, an excellent idea. And one that promotes, of course, an underlying theme of these games of peace and unity.
And isn't it great to see the energy from the athletes? They've had a long campaign. We spoke about the campaign that they've had, and they're involved in grueling sports. But the one thing you know, when you come to a closing ceremony, you're going to see a lot of smiles. You are going to see energy from the athletes because it's a release for them. This is the party night of the Olympic Games.
Yeah, there's that sense of almost relief, the release of the energy that you've made it to the end. There has been some failure, some success, but all the athletes have come together over these past few weeks, and what they can absolutely say for sure is they have all done their best.
And of course, it's hard not to have energy when you've got a band like this playing. Second Moon, fantastic music, really, just can't stop moving to it. That's one way to make an entrance.
The only difficulty with that is it's very hard to take a selfie when you come in like that.
That's true. It's catching. Team from People's Republic of China, who of course will be hosting the next Winter Olympic Games in 2022 in Beijing.
And there will be later in the ceremony the traditional presentation from the next host, Beijing. It's a really interesting idea, and it's something that has already been embraced by the Chinese people, and we'll talk more about that when we come to the Beijing segment later on. But already in excess of 60 million people have got themselves involved in an idea surrounding the Beijing Winter Olympics in 2022.
You mentioned countries that you wouldn't necessarily see at a Winter Olympic Games. Well, there is Togo, one of eight National Olympic Committees from the continent of Africa that have taken part in these games, and that's a record for a Winter Olympic Games. And within that, announced that 10 women from the continent of Africa qualified for these Winter Olympic Games. Team Austria, who dominated the Alpine skiing events, perhaps not as strongly as they did in Sochi, but still the powerhouse in the Alpine skiing category.
And as I did in the opening ceremony, the athletes will, after their parade lap, go into an area specially designated for the athletes where they will be able to sit and watch the ceremony. And then later on, as tradition would dictate, they'll all invade the middle area again and intermingle as one nation, effectively, at the end of these Olympic Winter Games.
We just saw the red jackets of the Norway team. A record total number of medals for Norway, 39 for any Winter Olympic Games. Ecuador, we mentioned them as one of the National Olympic Committees making their Winter Games debuts.
We haven't seen anybody shirtless yet.
No, which we did get a view of in the opening ceremonies.
We saw the Czech Republic team coming in a little earlier on, and of course, one of their number, Ester Ledecká, recording an amazing feat, winning gold in two separate events, or sports in fact, not events, here at the Winter Olympic Games. The first woman to do so, gold in the women's Super G, and then a week later, gold in snowboard parallel giant slalom. What an amazing feat that is.
Well, to note, coming away with the win at the women's Alpine Super G by 1/100th of a second, it was just spectacular. And able to follow that up with the win in her, her stronger event that she's been training for a little more regularly.
I think it would be fair to say that is her stronger event.
Yes.
The twice a world champion. 120 of the 40 races she's raced on the World Cup Tour in parallel giant slalom snowboard. And sometimes for an athlete like that, it's quite difficult to transform that onto the Olympic stage because everybody expects you to win. But she handled that with consummate ease.
And we do see that at the Olympic Games, that the form that athletes come into the Olympics, they're on top on the regular World Cup season, but it doesn't always play out at the Olympic Games. The pressure gets to them, the nerves overcome them. And it's sometimes those that are sitting ranked lower down in the 5th to 10th place that come through with those Olympic medals, the wins.
We mentioned Ledecká's two goals. There's also another lady who's achieved a similar feat, medals in two different sports. That's Joan Ten Moors, ladies 1,000 meters in speed skating, and then bronze in the ladies 3,000 relay in short track.
And that was also in world record time, that bronze medal. They actually skated in the B final, and because of what happened in the A final that followed them, they were elevated up to the bronze medal position. It was an amazing night. By the way, we mentioned Peter Tofa Tofua, who was the man who made headlines around the world when he came into the Olympic Stadium in Rio shirtless, and he did the same thing here. I think he was probably blue by the end of the opening ceremony. He said that he fulfilled his ambition in these games. He finished the men's 15 kilometre free without hitting a tree.
Well, and it was, you know, that is the men's 15 kilometre free in the cross country was a notable moment that I witnessed to see the final competitor, the Mexican, German Madrazi, come across and the finishers before him lifted him, hoisted him up on their shoulders. And it was just a beautiful thing to watch, the spirit of the Olympics really coming together in that moment.
Also perhaps a mention for Japan ski jumper Noriaki Kasai, who's participated in his 8th Winter Olympic Games here in Pyeongchang 2018. That is a phenomenal feat.
A few of the Australians in amongst them, not necessarily recognised as a Olympic Winter Games nation, but they've got a few medals to their credit after the past couple of weeks here in Pyeongchang.
There are the Dutch in their unmissable orange jackets.
And they had a very good Olympic Games, and most of it was because of what their speed skaters were able to do. They were brilliant, and you mentioned that short track speed skating performance as well, but most of it was on the long track. Some of the greatest to ever grace the ice in action for the Netherlands, and they did it again. They did it in Sochi, and they've done it again 4 years later at the speed skating.
Team Germany had a very successful Games, equaling the record along with Norway in these Games of Canada's from 2010 of 14 gold medals.
Well, and we've noted a little bit about the weather, the challenges that we saw, events being cancelled and moved to other days, and the athletes able to hold together. It's a challenge when events get changed, and also to perform under these difficult weather conditions. We saw high winds, especially the biathletes out at the center having to shoot under these windy conditions and keep their focus.
And a fair percentage of the Korean team now coming into the stadium to the delight of the president and everybody else here in this 35,000 seat stadium. So many great moments for Korea, but one of the ones that they crave, they got less than 24 hours ago, and it was when Lee Sung-hoon won the mass start at the speed skating, and that place was rocking to its foundations last night. He's a hero in this part of the world, and he became even more of a hero, the Olympic champion from Vancouver 8 years ago in the 10,000 metres, and that victory last night was something to behold.
Our youngest medalist at these Games, Alina Zagatova, Olympic athlete of Russia. So 15 years and 270 days, silver in the figure skating team event. She won gold in the singles event as well. And at the other end of the scale, we have Riikka Valio of Finland, who at 44 years and 255 days was the oldest medalist at these Olympic Winter Games. She won bronze with Finland ice hockey tournament.
Now here's a mascot closest to us who's become very familiar to us, Surang, the mascot of these Games, and with Surang, the mascot of the Games that were held 30 years ago in South Korea when the Olympic Games were held in Seoul so successfully.
His name was Hodori. And they are bringing up the rear of the parade. And Second Moon continue to pump out the tunes. Nigeria, Ghana and Togo all marching together.
I think this is where this stadium comes to the fore. It's an intimate stadium, only 35,000 people here. And it's got the feel for everyone, speaking to a couple of the people who were involved in the opening ceremony, that everybody is on top of you. And it creates this wonderful atmosphere for the athletes.
Well, I think it's because it's been specifically designed for the ceremonies. There's been no sport here, so they've been able to design it with this specific event in mind. Look at the reaction from the crowd. Fantastic to see.
And we said during the opening ceremony that for 2 days at least, this place has been the most important pentagon in the world.
You can be certain that the spectators feel the energy in this stadium. The athletes are feeling the energy that's building here at these closing ceremonies. And what a moment for these athletes to be able to come here, relax a little bit and have some fun and celebrate these Olympic Games.
And some of them will be having the thoughts that we discussed earlier. When the athletes walked around in Sochi 4 years ago, they started that thought process towards this moment. And some of them will be thinking, what an experience this has been. I can't wait for what happens in Beijing in China in 2022. So the preparations, in a lot of ways, begin right at this moment.
Surang up in the sky. We can see from our commentary position, it is actually up there in the sky. It is not computer animated.
Well, they're the drones, I'm sure, that they used at the opening ceremony, which was so spectacular. How about that? It's just appearing at the top of our commentary window, and that is a sight to behold. They used in excess of 1,200 drones for the opening ceremony to create the Olympic rings and the unforgettable images. And on a clear night in Pyeongchang, we've never seen something like that before at an Olympic Games.
That really is breathtaking. And as I say, that is actually happening in the sky above us now. There's absolutely no computer-generated images going on here. Well, they wanted to show off their technology here in the south of Korea, and they've done that.
Ladies and gentlemen, the athletes.
여러분, 평창을 빛내준 영웅들, 올림픽 선수들입니다.
The youngest of the athletes was 15 years of age, Wu Meng from China in the half pipe skiing. The oldest, Cheryl Bernard from Canada in curling at 51 years of age. The Olympic flame still burning brightly after that spectacular lighting at the opening ceremony going back more than 2 weeks ago. And so many people have got to see the flame in the last couple of weeks in this busy part of Pyeongchang. Now a journey to remember. This tradition began at the Olympic Games in Rio of 2016. A moment to celebrate the lives of those who have passed and gone to another world. And the turtle is part of the parade, traditionally considered a sacred animal in this part of the world. It's considered to be the messenger between humans and gods. The turtle journeying through the time tunnel, the boundary between life and death.
Mesdames et messieurs, les cérémonies des vainqueurs du ski de fond départ en masse.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremonies for cross-country skiing mass start classic.
지금부터 크로스컨트리 스키 남녀 단체 출발 클래식 종목의 시상식이 있겠습니다.
It's an incredible moment for an athlete. Wherever you receive your Olympic medals, to do it on this stage must be just remarkable.
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
Please welcome the medalists.
여러분, 메달리스트들을 환영해 주십시오.
Now arriving in the stadium, your medalists, the ladies' 30-kilometer mass start classic.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs du ski de fond départ en masse 30 km femmes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for ladies' 30-kilometer mass start classic.
지금부터 크로스컨트리 스키 여자 30km 단체 출발 클래식 종목의 시상식을 시작하겠습니다.
Les médailles seront remises par
The medals will be presented by
메달 시상자를 소개하겠습니다.
Thomas Barr, président du Comité international olympique, champion olympique d'escrime en 1976.
Thomas Barr, president of the International Olympic Committee, Olympic champion in fencing 1976.
Thomas Barr, 국제 올림픽 위원회 위원장입니다. 올림피안 1976년에 펜싱 종목에서 한 개의 금메달을 수상한 경력이 있습니다.
Accompanied
by
다음은 시상품 시상자입니다.
Monsieur Gianfranco Casper, Suisse, président de la Fédération internationale de ski.
Mr. Gianfranco Casper, Switzerland, president of the International Ski Federation.
스위스의 잔프랑코 카스퍼 국제 올림픽 위원회 위원입니다.
Médaille de bronze, Suède.
Bronze medalist, Sweden.
동메달, 스웨덴.
Stina Nilsson.
Your bronze medalist, Stina Nilsson. This is her third medal of here in Pyeongchang at these Olympic Winter Games. And she becomes the third Swedish woman to win at least five medals at the Olympic Winter Games, joining Charlotte Kalla from cross country, who won 9 medals, and Anja Persson in alpine, who won 6.
Médaille d'argent, Finland.
Silver medalist, Finland.
은메달, Finland.
Kirsta Parmakoski.
Your silver medalist in the ladies' 30K Mass Start Classic. This medal here, her third medal of the Pyeongchang 2018 Winter Olympic Games.
Championne olympique, Norvège.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion, Norway.
금메달, Olympic champion, Norway.
Marit Bjørgen.
Well, your Olympic champion, Marit Bjørgen. She collects here her 8th gold medal at an Olympic Winter Games. This equaling the record set by athlete Bjørn Dalen from Norway and the cross-country skier Bjørn Dali. This also brings her total medal record to 15, which breaks the previous record of 13 medals set by Bjørn Dalen of Norway.
Mesdames et messieurs, merci de vous lever pour l'hymne de la Norvège.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem of Norway.
여러분, 노르웨이의 국가 연주가 있겠습니다. 모두 자리에서 일어나 주시기 바랍니다.
And there they are, your medalists from the women's 30-kilometer mass start classic.
Mesdames, messieurs, les médaillés olympiques.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Olympic medalists.
여러분, 올림픽 메달리스트들입니다.
And that truly is another chapter added to one of the great Winter Olympic stories.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs du ski de fond départ en masse 50 km hommes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for men's 50 km mass start classic.
지금부터 크로스 컨트리 스키 남자 50km 단체 출발 클래식 종목의 시상식을 시작하겠습니다.
So now we move to the men's 50 km mass start classic.
Athlète olympique de Russie.
Bronze medalist, Olympic athlete from Russia.
동메달, 러시아 출신 올림픽 선수.
Andrei Larkov.
Andrei Larkov, 28 years of age. His first Winter Olympic Games, his second medal after silver in the 4x10 kilometer relay. What a debut he has had at the Winter Olympic Games. Two hours, 10 minutes, 59 seconds for his bronze medal. A brilliant performance by Andrei Larkov.
Médaille d'argent, athlète olympique de Russie.
Silver medalist, Olympic athlete from Russia.
은메달, 러시아 출신 올림픽 선수.
Alexander Bolshunov.
Alexander Bolshunov, 21 years of age. His first Winter Olympic Games, his fourth medal. Bronze in the sprint classic, silver in the team sprint free, silver in the 4x10 kilometer relay, and now silver in the men's 50 kilometer mass start classic. 2 hours, 8 minutes, 40 seconds, his time for his fourth medal of these games. What a debut he has had here in Pyeongchang 2018.
Champion olympique, Finlande.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion, Finland.
금메달, Olympic champion, Finland.
Ivo Niskanen.
Ivo Niskanen, for the second time in his career, stands on the top step of an Olympic podium. Gold in the men's team sprint in Sochi 4 years ago. He now takes gold in the men's 50-kilometer mass start classic. In a time of 2 hours, 8 minutes and 22 seconds. And he becomes Finland's first gold medalist at these games. And it is the 22nd National Olympic Committee to win a gold. And that equals the record set in Sochi 4 years ago. Only the second time in these games that Olympic athletes from Russia have had two athletes on the podium. But they are silver and bronze.
Mesdames et messieurs, merci de vous lever. Ivo Niskanen
of Finland. And now we'll have the Finland national anthem.
For the national anthem of Finland.
여러분, 핀란드의 국가 연주가 있겠습니다. 모두 자리에서 일어나 주시기 바랍니다.
What an emotional moment for Ivo Niskanen. The Olympic champion in the men's 50-kilometer mass start. And the final victory ceremony of the Pyeongchang 2018 Winter Olympic Games.
And a lot of the ceremonies have been held in the Medals Plaza, just not far from the Olympic Stadium. A couple of venues, but what a venue for that to be held for those six individuals tonight. The eyes of the world on Pyeongchang at the closing ceremony. It would have been an indelible moment wherever it was, but for it to be here is something they'll never forget. And now a segment titled The Axis of New Time. The progression of numbers representing the existing concept of time ebbing away in the valley of time. With the number at zero, the people of the future prepare to break free from existing time and space and arrive at a world no longer bound by gravity.
Oh.
the dance in the segment, expressing the intrepid spirit and the ceaseless progress of the humanity in a new world.
Fantastic choreography. 40 dancers choreographed by Cha Jin-yob.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez souhaiter la bienvenue aux membres nouvellement élus du Comité international olympique et de sa commission des athlètes.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the newly elected members of the International Olympic Committee and its athletes commission.
다음은 2018 평창 동계올림픽을 통해 새롭게 선출된 국제올림픽위원회 신임 선수위원을 소개하겠습니다.
Kikan Randall, États-Unis d'Amérique, ski de fond.
Kikan Randall, United States of America, cross-country skiing.
Cross-country ski, 미국, Kikan Randall.
Emma Terho, Finland, hockey sur glace.
Emma Terho, Finland, ice hockey.
Ice hockey, Finland, Emma Terho.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez souhaiter la bienvenue aux représentants des volontaires de Pyeongchang 2018.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the representatives of the volunteers for Pyeongchang 2018.
여러분, 2018 평창 동계 올림픽 대회 자원봉사자들을 소개합니다.
And everywhere you go around Pyeongchang, you see those uniforms.
Les membres nouvellement élus du CIO et de sa commission des athlètes vont maintenant remettre des fleurs aux représentants des volontaires de Pyeongchang 2018 pour les remercier de leur contribution aux Jeux.
On behalf of all athletes, the newly elected members of the IOC and its athletes commission will present gifts of appreciation to the volunteer representatives of Pyeongchang 2018 to thank them for their contribution.
새로 선출된 신임 선수위원들이 모든 선수들을 대표해 자원봉사자 대표에게 감사의 마음을 전달하고 있습니다.
And the bouquets they receive are made of cotton balls, a symbol of warmth for the volunteers who have contributed so much throughout these games. And their smiles and their enthusiasm has been infectious, and that is a pretty good selfie to have.
Merci à vous, les volontaires.
Thank you, volunteers.
평창의 곳곳을 밝혀준 자원봉사자 여러분, 감사합니다.
The energy in this closing ceremony has been evident from the word go. It is about to go up a notch.
This is for all my bad girls around the world. Not bad meaning bad, but bad meaning good, you know. Let's light it up and let it burn like we don't care. Let them know how it feels damn good to be bad.
G-I-Z to the I-B-E.
These are the talents of Siao, one of K-pop's most recognizable faces.
Set them on fire. Ayo, ayo. I heard you were looking for me. Hey, hey. Where are my bad girls at?
And if you're wondering, this is one of their most popular songs. Lead singer for a band called 21. This is going to get plenty of crowd participation.
Oh my God.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez maintenant vous lever pour l'hymne national de la Grèce.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem of Greece.
여러분, 그리스 국가 연주와 함께 그리스 국기 개양이 있겠습니다. 모두 자리에서 일어나 주시기 바랍니다.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez rester debout pour l'hymne olympique interprété par Yeonjun Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the Olympic anthem performed by Yeonjun Oh.
이어서 올림픽 찬가와 함께 올림픽 길을 내리겠습니다. 올림픽 찬가는 오연준 군이 부르겠습니다.
And this young man steps onto the stage in front of the world at just 11 years of age.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez accueillir le président du Comité international olympique, Thomas Barr, accompagné du maire de Pyeongchang, Cheguk Shim, et du maire de Pékin, Chun Jining, pour la transmission du drapeau olympique.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the president of the International Olympic Committee, Thomas Bach, accompanied by the mayor of Pyeongchang, Jae-guk Shim, and the mayor of Beijing, Chun Ji-ning, for the Olympic flag handover.
다음은 차기계 최도시인 베이징의 올림픽기를 전달하겠습니다. 1976년 올림픽 펜싱 챔피언인 국제올림픽위원회 토마스 바흐 위원장과 심 제국 평창 구운수 천 지이닝 베이징 시장을 환영해 주시기 바랍니다.
Le maire de Pyeongchang va transmettre le drapeau olympique au président du CIO qui le confiera ensuite au maire de Pékin, ville hôte des prochains Jeux olympiques d'hiver.
The mayor of Pyeongchang will hand over the Olympic flag to the president of the IOC, who will then entrust it to the mayor of Beijing, the host city of the next Olympic Winter Games.
시임제국 평창 군수로부터 올림픽기를 건네받은 토마스 바흐 위원장이 천 지이닝 베이징 시장에게 올림픽기를 전달하겠습니다.
And so, in lots of ways, a journey that is going to take 4 years has officially begun.
Mesdames et messieurs, veuillez vous lever pour l'hymne national de la République populaire de Chine.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem of the People's Republic of China.
이어서 중국 국가 연주와 함께 중국 국기 개양이 있겠습니다. 모두 자리에서 일어나 주시기 바랍니다. 모두 자리에 앉아 주시기 바랍니다.
Mesdames et messieurs, la présentation de Pékin 2022.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Beijing 2022 presentation.
다음은 2022년 동계 올림픽의 개최지인 베이징을 소개하는 공연이 있겠습니다.
This presentation entitled 2022, See You in Beijing. And of course, naturally, it would have to feature one of the most famous symbols of China, the panda. A total of 24 roller skaters, 24 ice screens, representing the 24th Olympic Winter Games in 4 years' time. And now the shapes evolve into a Chinese phoenix that is spreading its wings. The long, or the Chinese dragon, and the phoenix are in Chinese culture symbols of good fortune, representing the Chinese people's good wishes and blessings for the Winter Olympics in 4 years' time. And the smiling faces of children from all around the world, representing the international nature of the Olympic Games, and a sign of the host nation saying, everybody is welcome. And now on the screens we see the symbols of all the Olympic Winter Games that have gone by. And now the pandas are making their way back to China. They travelled through a time tunnel to collect invitations which have come from Chinese people all over the nation. There was a competition held for people of China to submit invitations to people from all the other countries of the world. At last count, they had in excess of 60 million replies. And that was after about 6 days. And even the Chinese President Xi Jinping involved. So now, with invitations in hand, the pandas fly back through the internet tunnel and arrive back in Pyeongchang. And there is a symbol we're all going to become very familiar with. Beijing 2022, the host of the 24th edition of the Olympic Winter Games.
Mesdames et messieurs, merci d'accueillir le président et directeur général du comité d'organisation de Pyeongchang pour les Jeux Olympiques et Paralympiques d'hiver 2018, Hee-bom Lee, et le président du comité international olympique, Thomas Barr, champion olympique d'escrime en 1976.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the President and CEO of the Pyeongchang Organizing Committee for the 2018 Olympic and Paralympic Winter Games, Hee-bom Lee, and the President of the International Olympic Committee, Thomas Bach, Olympic champion fencing 1976.
여러분, 2018 평창 동계올림픽 대회 및 동계 패럴림픽 조직위원회 이희범 조직위원장과 1976년 올림픽 펜싱 챔피언인 국제올림픽위원회 토마스 바흐 위원장을 박수로 맞이해 주십시오.
(존경하는) 문재인 대통령님 대여분과 대한민국 국민 여러분, 토마스 바흐 IOC 위원장을 비롯한 지구촌 올림픽 가족 여러분, 내외 귀빈과 선수단 여러분, 17일 전 바로 이 시간 이 자리에서 만남의 기쁨을 나눈 것이 엊그제 같습니다. 이제 작별 인사를 나누기 위해 다시 모였습니다. 회자 정리, 즉 만남에는 헤어짐이 있습니다.
The Pocock president saying, just 2 weeks ago, we gathered here together to share the joy of coming together. Right at this time and right at this place. Now we come here together again to say goodbye.
여러분은 치열한 경쟁 속에서도 탁월함과 우월 그리고 존중이라는 올림픽 정신을 실천한 챔피언입니다.
The president quotes William Shakespeare, who once said at Romeo and Juliet, parting is such sweet sorrow. Even though we are now saying goodbye to each other, Pyeongchang 2018 will be long remembered with beautiful and unforgettable memories.
Korea 단일 팀으로 참가한 선수 여러분 모두가 승리자입니다. 결승선을 통과한 선수가 눈물을 쏟아내자 관중들은 아낌없이 기립박수를 보내며 울지 말을 연호했습니다. 승자와 패자는
He talks about the achievement of setting new Olympic records, athletes having achieved human victory over falling over 7 times but getting up 8. Talking about athletes having participated for the first time from Africa, athletes having taken part in the Games from a tropical zone with no winter season, athletes having set new records despite falling down in the course of competition, and of course, importantly, athletes having participated as unified Korean team. He says, all of you are truly winners.
여러분들은 진정 애국자이며 영웅입니다. 매섭고 추운 날씨와 열악한 여건 속에서도 묵묵히 맡은 바 소임을 다하고
The president also congratulating the volunteers who have come from 67 countries to be here.
희생정신으로
He calls them truly patriots and heroes.
감사합니다. 아울러 아울러 평창의 성공을 위해서 함께 하시다가 상처를 입거나 불의의 사고를 당하신 분들께도 위로와 사과의 말씀을 드립니다.
He talked about that magnificent moment when marching together and even competing together as a unified Korean team. It constituted a strong identity of one single nation. And the spectators in the stands shouted, "We are one."
우정을 나누었습니다. 특히 남북한 선수들이 쌓은 우정은 스포츠를 넘어 더 큰 가능성을 보여주었습니다. 함께 입장하고 또 단일팀으로 고락을 같이 한
He says the time is near for the Olympic flame to end its role following 17 day long, burning bright with so many unforgettable stories left behind. Even though it was a short period, Korea was happy because of your warm-hearted passion and friendship. We will never forget you. The president also says that one day in the future, he sincerely hopes and wishes that our children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren will remember all of us here at this moment as contributors to making an historic cornerstone leading to the peace on the Korean Peninsula.
Goodbye and see you again in Beijing. Thank you all.
Pyeongchang. Chers amis olympiques du monde entier, Votre Excellence, Monsieur Moon Jae-in, Président de la République de Corée, cher Président du Pocock, Monsieur Lee Hee-bom, chers athlètes, Excellences, chers membres de la famille olympique, Mesdames, Messieurs, au cours des 17 derniers jours, nous avons vécu de Jeux olympiques ancrés dans la tradition et ouvrant la voie de l'avenir. Il illustre parfaitement les paroles de notre fondateur Pierre de Coubertin lorsqu'il disait « Les Jeux olympiques sont un pèlerinage au passé et un acte de foi dans l'avenir. The Olympic Games are a homage to the past and an act of faith in the future. A true homage to the past was the respect of the Olympic truce, just as it was 3,000 years ago in ancient Olympia. Dear athletes from the NOCs of the Republic of Korea and the Democratic People's Republic of Korea, with your joint march, you have shared your faith in a peaceful future with all of us. You have shown how sport brings people together in our very fragile world. You have shown how sport builds bridges. The IOC will continue this Olympic dialogue even after we extinguish the Olympic flame. In this, we are driven by our faith in the future. These Olympic Winter Games have introduced new events that appeal to new generations. Digital technology has enabled more people in more countries to see winter sports in more ways. We have brought together a record number of national Olympic committees participating in Olympic Winter Games. Therefore, I can truly say the Olympic Winter Games Pyeongchang 2018 are the Games of new horizons. We are embracing these new horizons We offer our hand to everybody to join forces in this faith in the future. Dear athletes, you are the best ambassadors of our optimism. Thank you for sharing it with all of us. Thank you for your competitive spirit. Thank you for your fair play. To the organizers of the Olympic Winter Games Pyeongchang 2018, I say thank you from the bottom of my heart. I congratulate you for showing us new horizons. For your contributions, I thank the International Winter Sports Federations, the participating National Olympic Committees, our sponsors, and the television rights holders. To the President of the Republic of Korea, Your Excellency Moon Jae-in, I say thank you for your personal commitment and determination to make these games so successful in every way. To the volunteers, I say a special thank you. I say a special thank you for warming our hearts even at the coldest temperatures. Javon Bongsaja Yorobun. Honchin E. Kamsamida. To our gracious hosts, the people of Korea, I say Kamsamida. Athletes from the five continents of the world and future host countries of the Olympic Games would like to join in these thanks. Martin Fourcade, Noka Daira, Sheon Adigun, Yun Sung Bin, Riem Deok, Lindsay Won, Liu Xiaju, Peter Taufa Tofua. Welcome. Together, we would like to express our gratitude with the typical Korean gesture of a heart, which we have appreciated so much during these Olympic Winter Games. And now it is my obligation to declare the Olympic Winter Games Pyeongchang 2018 closed. In accordance with tradition, I call upon the youth of the world to assemble 4 years from now in Beijing, People's Republic of China, to celebrate with us all the 24th Olympic Winter Games. Thank you and bye-bye, Korea.
And so as we come to the end of the 17-day journey, which has been a celebration of passion, fighting spirit, and harmony, The ceremony continues with many of the Korean traditions. But they are traditions interwoven into the modern world.
Go back to K-pop now. This is EXO. And they're singing their song Growl.
We got that power, power. 네가 나를 볼 때. feeling as we don't take time. We take shots, we take shots. The last time we go bang bang pow wow. We are put that going on. Now with the melody low. She got us on the go. Do you know? We got that power every time.
And they're not just popular in this part of the world. Their first album reached number one on the Billboard World Albums chart. That was EXO. And here comes a familiar figure. Or in fact, a few familiar figures. Remember them from the opening ceremony? The five children who lit up the world at this place just a couple of weeks ago. And they bring with them a very big present box. And fittingly, Sarang. 10 Sarangs out there with them. Beautiful snow globe with the magnificent landscape of Pyeongchang inside. And the box reveals now some of the memories that have lit up our hearts and the hearts of the world over the last 17 days. And now the five children and 10 Sarangs are joined by 400 performers. and with the giant snowflake forming now, the stadium now resembles the snow globe and the beautiful scene inside it. The president has just declared the games closed, and now, with that symbolic gesture, we officially say goodbye to the Pyeongchang Games of 2018. But as we do say goodbye, we also think of what is the new beginning. If Korea is going to say goodbye, they will say goodbye with joy. And so then, an opportunity for the athletes now to join the performers. DJ Raiden has got the party started, and the athletes will now mix with the performers, the five children who have become such familiar faces to us in our time in Pyeongchang. It's time to say farewell, but to do it with a smile on our faces. All in all, 674 performers coming together in the middle of the stage, and that doesn't include the hundreds and the thousands of athletes who are now making their way into the middle of the arena to join the party. And the athletes from all nations and the performers enjoying this brilliant atmosphere in the stadium. In particular, the athletes from the Netherlands, because after all, it's one of their own, Martin Garrix, who had this place jumping.
This concludes the closing ceremony of the 2018 Pyeongchang Olympic Winter Games. See you in Beijing. Thank you and good night.
이것으로 제23회 평창 동계올림픽 폐회식의 모든 순서를 마치겠습니다. 2022년 베이징에서 다시 만나겠습니다. 모두 안녕히 돌아가십시오.
What a brilliant way to say goodbye. That was fabulous.
The energy was incredible, and throughout the whole ceremonies, it really echoed what we felt over these past 17 days here at the Pyeongchang Olympic Games.
Yeah, absolutely loved it. Thought it was brilliant, a fitting end to a wonderful, 2.5 weeks of sporting brilliance.
And one of the things I loved about the performance tonight was the young performers, the brilliance of the 11-year-old singer, the 13-year-old guitarist. It's the future of this nation, and it's been on display tonight.
Outstanding, isn't it? I mean, yeah. Nerveless. nerveless. I mean, fantastic performances.
So the fireworks, traditionally part of the closing ceremony, and we remember what a brilliant period it's been in this part of the world. So it's the end of a journey which began at the turn of this century. Two unsuccessful bids to host the Olympics are now just a distant memory. Pyeongchang has taken her final bow and the world has been watching. Thank you, Korea, or as they say in this part of the world, 감사합니다. And thanks to you, wherever you are around the world too. We hope you've loved it as much as we have. For now then, it's goodbye from Pyeongchang and the 23rd Olympic Winter Games. See you in Beijing in 2022.